Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now again we are making more videos. Already series of videos are started. So now the next continuation video. So today we need to know about HTML introduction. Till we know what is web technologies and what are the keywords used in web technologies. Now we are learning HTML introduction. HTML is nothing but hypertext markup language introduced by, now we need to discuss history of HTML, DOM tree, document, object, model, and HTML versions, and HTML structure and document type. The first one, history of HTML. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. Hypertext markup language. It is official language of the WWW World Wide Web and was first convened in 1990. It is the authorizing language used to create documents on the web WWW. HTML is the product of HGML, that is standard generalized markup language. Means actually Tim Berners-Lee suggested HTML, but he finally provided HTML. This is the HTML. HTML is the subset of HTML. Now HTML is a language for describing web pages. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. HTML is a markup language. And a markup language is a set of markup tags. The tags describe document content. HTML documents contains HTML tags and plain text. HTML documents are also called as web pages. So already we mentioned that markup tags are of two types. One is pair tags and non-pair tags. Pair tags have starting as well as the ending. But non-pair tags have only one tag we are discovering. So the next one is DOM tree. DOM tree means document object model. Is a programming interface for HTML and XML. XML means extensible markup language. It defines the logical structure of the documents and the way a document is accessed and manipulated. DOM is a way to represent the web page in the structured hierarchical way so that it will become easier for programmers and users to guild through the document. With DOM, we can easily access and manipulate tags, IDs, classes, attributes, or elements using comments or methods provided by document object. Structure of the DOM. DOM can be thought of as tree or forest. The term structure model is sometimes used to describe the tree-like representation of a document. One important property of DOM structure model is structural isomorphism. If any two DOM implementations are used to create a representation of the same document, they will create the same structure model with precisely the same objects and relationships. Why called as object model? Documents are modeled using objects, and the model includes not only the structure of the document but also the behavior of a document and the objects of which it is composed of, like tag elements with attributes in HTML. Properties of DOM. So here windows followed by documents. Documents classified into three things. One is link, form, and anchor tag. Okay, again the forms are classified into text area, check boxes, radio button, select button, buttons, reset. Again, the select is having option. These all are the different tags available. Link is the one tag, form is one tag, anchor is one tag, okay, text area is one tag, checkbox. These are the different things we will learn in the later PPTs. And window object is always at top of hierarchy. Document object: when HTML document is loaded into a window, it becomes a document object. Form object: it is represented by form tags. Link objects: it is represented by link tags. Anchor objects: it is represented by a href tags. Form control elements: form can have many control elements such as text fields, buttons, radio buttons, and text checkboxes. Methods of the document object: write string writes the given string on the document. Get element by id returns the element having the given id value. Get elements by name returns all the elements having the given name value. Get elements by tag name returns all the elements having the given tag name. Get elements by class name returns all the elements having the given class name. These methods are used in JavaScript. You can understand when we are learning JavaScript. So if we write the HTML code, a piece of HTML code, then the equivalent diagram will be drawn like this. First one is the table, next rows, next is the row part, next is the tr, this is one tr and this is second tr. Again, in this tr, two TDs are there, one is car and one is scooter. In the second tr, again two TDs are there, one is motorbike and second one is the bus. This is the way we are constructing a DOM tree for an HTML page or XML page. Now, what DOM is not? The document object model is not a binary description where it does not define any binary source code in its interface. The document object model is not used to describe objects in XML or HTML, whereas the DOM describes XML and HTML documents as objects. The document object model is not represented by set of data structures. It is an interface which specifies object representation. The document object model does not show criticality of objects in documents. It does not have information about which object in document is appropriate to the content and which is not. Now, DOM 3 have three levels: level 0, level 1, level 2 and level 3. Four levels of the DOM are four: level 0, level 1, level 2 and level 3. In the level 0 provides the low level set of interface. In the level 1, we represent DOM level 1 can be described in two parts: one is core and second one is the HTML. Core provides a low level interfaces that can be used to represent any structured document. HTML provides high level interfaces that can be used to represent HTML document. And level 2 consists of 6: core 2, views, events, style, trousel and range. Core 2 extends the functionality of core specified by DOM level 1. Views allows programs to dynamically access and manipulate content of the document. Events are scripts that is either executed by browser when user reacts to web page. Style allows programmers to dynamically access and manipulate content of style sheets. Trousers allows programs to dynamically traverse the document. Range allows programmers to dynamically identify a range of content in document. So level 3 consists of 5 file specifications, core 3, load, save, validation, events, and XPath. Core 3 extends functionality of core specified by DOM level 2. Load and save allows program to dynamically load the content of XML document into DOM document and save the DOM document into XML document by serialization. Validation allows program to dynamically update the content and structure of document while ensuring document remains valid. Events extends functionality of events specified by DOM level 2. XPath. XPath is a path language that can be used to access DOM tree. So the next one is HTML versions, and first HTML is introduced in 1991. The present versions are HTML5 and XHTML5. These are introduced in 2012 and 2013. HTML plus is the next version, HTML 2.0, HTML 3.2, HTML 4.0, HTML 4.01, XHTML 1.0, XHTML 2.0. these are the different versions available in HTML. So now what we are doing is we need to learn HTML version and what are the features available in that version. First, HTML 1.0, the first version of HTML that supported inline and text control. HTML 1.0 was very limited in terms of styling and presentation. So use tables, specify fonts, change page background, use of forms. These are the four features available in HTML 1.0. Next, HTML 2.0 was the first classic version of HTML. The HTML 2.0 was introduced on 24th November 1995. HTML 2.0 constituted almost all the elements but lacked with the extensions for Netscape and Microsoft. In HTML 2.0, tables are poor in aligning attributes. HTML 3.2. After HTML 2.0, the next major version development was HTML 3, which happened in late 1995. But HTML 3 development did not get completed and it was never implemented. The next major release after HTML 2.0 was the HTML 3.2, a version released by W3C. The HTML 2.0's IETF ended its HTML working group in September 1996. HTML 3.2 was published in January 1997. HTML 3.2 included tables, attribute alignment, images, headings, and few more. HTML2 is understood by all the browsers. Now HTML 4.0. HTML 4.0 was the next major release of HTML. HTML 4.0 was introduced in December 1997. HTML4 is an HTML application. HTML4 phased out Netscape visual features by supporting style sheets. It supports style sheets, means CSS, cascading style sheets. HTML 4.0 enhanced browser explicit features. However, in April 1998, HTML 4 was reissued with small changes. Now, HTML 4.0.1 is the current official version of HTML. HTML 1.0.1 enhanced most trademarked extensions. In December 1999, HTML 4.0.1 came into existence with the support of internationalized documents, CSS, added table forms with JSS. Now, XHTML 1.0, reformulating HTML and in XML. XHTML 1.1 evaluated out of the work surrounding the initial modelization of TML specification. XHTML stands for Extensible Hypertext Markup Language. XHTML 2.0. XHTML 2.0, a new version of XHTML, able to make a clean break from the past by discarding the requirement of background compatibility. HTML forms were to be replaced by X forms. HTML frames were to be replaced with X frames. The DOM event were to be replaced by XML events, which uses the XML document object model. This is the latest version, HTML 5. HTML 5 is the latest version of HTML. HTML 5 came into life on January 2008. HTML 5 included its own HTML serialization along with XML based HTML 5 serialization. HTML syntax brings to mind HTML syntax. Now, the structure of HTML, it consists of document type. Next is the HTML, followed by head section and followed by body section. In head section, we have 6 tags. It describes the head section. In body section, more tags are available. We need to learn about these two parts in detail in the later section. Thank you. In the HTML structure, the first one is the document type. Document type, using doc type, the web browser decides version of HTML or XHTML. The doc type declaration helps the browser to display a web page correctly. There are many different documents on the web and a browser can only display an HTML page 100% correctly. If it knows the HTML type and version used, and the HTML doc type for HTML 5, we need to represent it this way. For HTML 4.01, strict like this, transitional like this, we can represent. Thank you.